Today we are going to study regulated and unregulated power supply. So any power supply requires, first one is a transformer, okay, and it is step down. In electronics we are using actually step down transformers because secondary voltage requirement is very low as compared to input, and input voltage is 230 volt AC, that is easily available with us, okay. And secondary voltage, it may be 5 volt, 10 volt, 14 volt, 12 volt, or say up to 40 volt, okay. So in this case, for example, it is 9 volt, okay. So it decreases the voltage level only, okay. This input voltage is high and output voltage is low because at the output we require, or we have to drive equipment that requires very low DC voltage. So we have used here a transformer, and that one is a step down transformer. Here we have to draw lines, it means it is iron core transformer, okay. So this is transformer 230 volt to 9 volt. And we require output DC voltage say about 9 volt. Then next part is here, the secondary voltage is also AC, input is also AC, we have not achieved this DC voltage. So to convert this AC voltage to DC voltage, we require rectifier, okay. So next block of this power supply is rectifier. Okay, so output of this transformer is fed to the rectifier circuit. So rectifiers are of three types: half wave rectifier, center type rectifier, and bridge rectifier. We prefer bridge type rectifier. So here we have used the say bridge type rectifier, so efficiency is very high, and at the output we get around 9 volt DC voltage. Okay, but we know that the output of rectifier is pulsating DC. Pulsating DC means here the output of the secondary is AC. That means the waveform is like this. Okay, and in case of full wave rectifiers, we get both half cycles at the output, but in only one direction. So output is like this. Means positive as well as negative half cycles are present at the output, but nature is pulsating, means it contains AC as well as DC. As it is in one direction only, therefore we say it is a DC, and there is a variations in the output voltage, so it is also AC. Means AC plus DC is present at the output. Now we have to use filter circuit that gives a more pure DC, means it removes the pulsations, okay. And for that purpose we use filter circuit. So next block is filter circuit. So give the output of rectifier to the filter, so that at the output of filter you get more pure DC, or the pulsations are removed, so the waveform is like this, okay, at the output. This is the waveform at the output of rectifier, and this is at the output of filter. Now you can connect a load at this output of filter, means the circuit which is to be operated is connected at the output of filter circuit. So this is called as load. So it is denoted by letter RL. Now see the blocks of this power supply. First one, transformer is required. Then to convert it is in DC, rectifier is required. To get more pure DC, we require filter circuit. Okay, so these are basic building blocks of any DC power supply. But we should know what is meant by regulated power supply and unregulated power supply. Okay, so here this power supply is actually unregulated power supply. Why it is called unregulated, that we have to see. Okay, and in this circuit, who is actually delivering the voltage to us? That one is a transformer. Transformer gives voltage, means this one is actually a voltage source. Okay, so this is voltage source, and we know that any voltage source is considered as EMF, source of EMF plus its internal resistance Rn. Okay, so this transformer has secondary, and secondary gives AC voltage, that means EMF is there, so we denoted it as EMF. And the secondary coil has some resistance, and that resistance is the internal resistance of this source. Okay, so here the series resistance is Rin, and that one is the internal resistance of this voltage source. Okay, this one is a voltage source, and its equivalent circuit of the secondary is written in this manner, that is EMF plus internal resistance. So whenever you connect your load at the output, before say rectification or after rectification, what happens actually, if the resistance, internal resistance of the source is high, then high voltage will drop across this internal resistance and less will appear across this load resistance. Okay, means as long as this RL is high, full EMF will appear across this RL, because as compared to Rin, if RL is very high, then full EMF voltage will appear across this load resistance. But if this internal resistance is high, then this EMF voltage will get divided into two parts, that is RL and Rin. Okay, and if its internal resistance is very high, then you will get less voltage at the output, means output is not remained constant. Okay, see here, if we used this one is a variable resistance, okay, then what happens when this resistance is high, medium and low, say only three values are considered. When it is high, then it will be equal to EMF voltage, whatever may be it will be available. But if we decrease the value of RL, what happens, it will draw more current this circuit, because total resistance will become less, and the voltage will appear across this resistance plus this. Now this resistance is decreased, so voltage across it is decreased, and voltage across Rin will increase, means when it is medium, what happens, the EMF or the voltage across, say voltage across RL, decreases. When it is low, then it again decreases. Okay, means with increasing load current, okay, load current, when load current increases, that means RL decreases, what happens, V output decreases, means as we increase the load current, output voltage drops, means output voltage does not remain constant because of this resistance, because the remaining part of the voltage appears. If this one is say very low again, or say zero, then full voltage will always appear across it, okay, when this resistance is high or medium or low, if there is a no internal resistance or very very in the range of say nano ohms, this resistance is very very low, then what happens, this there will be negligible effect on the output voltage. But if internal resistance is high, then the output voltage drops, and we actually observe that as the load increases, output voltage decreases. So such type of voltage source or power supply is called as unregulated power supply. Okay, the voltage regulator, the power supply whose output voltage drops with increase in load current, then such type of power supply is called as unregulated power supply. Actually, we need regulated power supply, means though there is a change in output load current, there should not be any change in output voltage, means we require a circuit or power supply that should be like this. As the load current increases, then also V out is equal to constant, output voltage should not change, means this should be very very low or zero. Okay, in the resistance should be very low or zero, ideally say zero. That time what happens, the full EMF will appear across this output resistance, and output voltage we say remains constant. So the difference between unregulated power supply and regulated power supply is that whatever is the voltage regulator, its resistance should be very low. Okay, that time it will give some regulation to the output voltage. But actually such type of transformer is not available, so we have to modify or we have to use another circuit at the output of this filter circuit, and that is called as voltage regulator. Designing power supply, we should know the regulation of transformer first, because if we have used a transformer having current rating 500 milliampere and another transformer which has secondary current rating is 2 ampere, this shows that as this current capacity is very low, means its internal resistance or the winding whose cross section area will be very low, and means its internal resistance Rin is very high. And in case of 2 ampere transformer, here the winding whose cross section area is large, okay, and therefore its resistance is low, and as its resistance is low, it delivers more current, means its internal resistance is low. Means while designing power supply, we have to use a transformer which having higher current capacity, so that automatically the output resistance or say input internal resistance of the source will decrease. Okay, धन्यवाद.